Hello Weeboos, first of all thanks for clicking on this video. I would really appreciate if you can stay till the end. In today's video, we are going to discuss about one of the most popular and heated manga series, that is Komi-san Can't Communicate. I had been refraining myself from making this video for a long time, but recently the water went above my head and I could no longer stay quiet. Komi-san Can't Communicate is a Japanese manga series written and illustrated by Tomihito Oda. As the titular name, the story of the manga follows a high school girl, Komi Shoko, who has communication disorder. On her very first day at high school, Komi-san becomes the center of attention due to her unprecedented stoic beauty and refined elegance that she possesses. Hito Tadano, a average high school with an immense amount of luck, gets the opportunity to sit beside Komi-san. Soon Tadano comes to know about Komi-san's communication disorder and decides to help her to make new friends. The manga further follows Komi-san's quest to make 100 friends with the help of Tadano. The manga is nothing but a normal high school manga with all the elements in it, such as school trip arc, annual fest arc, Valentine's Day, and confession arcs. The manga is all but normal until Komi-san comes into the picture. Komi-san is literally the goddess of her world. Even in the black-white manga panel, one can easily recognize her beauty and elegance, making the manga extraordinary by just one glance. Tadano, being as dumb as he can be, he can neither recognize her affection towards him, nevertheless breaking her heart and making her cry. In the first year of high school, Komi-san started to communicate through holy writings with her classmate and inadvertently making new friends. The issue arises in the second year of her high school life. Rumiko Manbagi. She is a Gairu and also the one who dares to compete with the goddess itself for her love, Tadano. Most of the second season follows the love rivalry among Komi-san and Rumiko. Even though Komi-san, being a goddess, finds it difficult to compete without expressing herself, and therefore she starts expressing her feelings by talking out with Tadano and Rumiko. The cursive font that represents Komi-san's speech are more than enough to represent her soft and tender voice, as Jesus is reciting the Holy Bible himself. The manga stands out in the crowd full of high school and romance mangas just because of Komi-san and her character development along this series. After 300 chapters, the manga has reached the confession arc where all three of them confess their love to each other. Along the main storyline, development of side characters and shippings is also one of the assets that this manga contains, which indeed makes it a unique piece of work. Personally, I was never interested in romance manga as they only leave a large hole in my heart and make me realize how lonely I am. I started Komi-san Can't Communicate in nothing but peer pressure of the fandom. But now I know, this manga is not about high school or teenage romance. This manga is all about a goddess and her daily life. Komi-san Can't Communicate is a heartwarming manga series which makes you feel better and cheer for Komi-san rather than leaving a void in your heart and like other romance manga series. In this time of pandemic, which spreads negativity among the people resulting into depression and anxiety, Komi-san is the one to whom you all should turn to. Komi-san is the perfect waifu one can ask for. With long black hair and tall, graceful appearance, she captures the attention of anyone who comes across her. On May 11, 2021, an anime adaptation by OLM was announced. And recently it was announced that it is to be scheduled to air in October 2021. After the toxic reaction of Attack on Titan fandom, I would give a hats off to the OLM studio for coming forward and animating the most awaited manga series of all time. As we all know, with great powers comes great responsibility. I hope OLM is able to give justice to this manga series, and I would also request my viewers and subscribers to support the artists and creators rather than nitpicking their mistakes. The manga is far from its end, but I would recommend it to weeps of every age group to give it a read once. We would be ending our review here. I have avoided all the major spoilers as there was nothing to begin with. If you think our video are appreciable, then please leave a like or comment for us. I am always grateful to my viewers and subscribers for staying with me. Thank you for staying till the end.